With the popularity of the timed up and go test as a clinical tool to assess a patient's functional mobility, it's no wonder that numerous variations of the test have been developed. These allow for clinicians to gain even more valuable information about their patients. This video is going to show you how to perform two variations on the timed up and go, or TUG test, and then discuss how a patient's performance can be used in the clinical setting. If you're looking for information on the basic timed up and go, be sure to check out our separate video on that test. You can find the link in the description below. Let's dive in. Out of the many TUG test variations, we're choosing two to discuss, which both include a dual task element, where the patient is asked to do something in addition to performing the TUG test. Both of these variations are best tested after performing the basic TUG, so that the two times can be compared. This also reduces the likelihood of performance errors, such as forgetting to sit down at the end of the test. Since all instructions for the basic TUG also apply to these variations, we won't be covering those in detail for this video. The first variation is the cognitive dual task TUG. In this version, the patient is asked to count backwards from 100 by threes, such as 100, 97, 94, 91, and so on. This cognitive task is performed for the entire duration of the test. Check out this example.
100, 97, 94, 91, 88, 85, 82, 79, 76, 73.
The cognitive dual task TUG is obviously a great measure for patients with cognitive deficits, but it also works well with the general population with any balance impairment. This is due to the higher level of focus and cognitive attention given to their balance. The second timed up and go variation is the manual or motor dual task TUG. One example of this is performing the TUG while carrying a glass of water. This can also be altered to be more specific to the patient's occupation, hobby, or a specific goal. Both of these variations result in a dual task time, which can be compared to their single task time, where no secondary activity was performed with the TUG. There's also been some research on calculating what is called the dual task cost, or the percent decline in performance under a dual task condition compared to a single task condition. Put simply, dual task cost is how much worse the patient performs the TUG when a second task is added. An example of this is if a patient completes the normal TUG in 10 seconds and the cognitive dual task TUG in 15 seconds. Using this equation, we find that the patient had a dual task cost of 50%, or a 50% decline in performance with dual tasking. You can find more info on all of this in our free Timed Up and Go Test Toolkit, available for download on missiongate.org under the Education tab. This toolkit includes everything you need to implement the TUG and its variations, from current clinical metrics to a ready-to-go in-service. We've also included the link in the description below. If you haven't already, check out our video on the basic Timed Up and Go Test by clicking the link at the end of this video. To stay up to date on our latest content, click the link in the corner to subscribe and be sure to like and share this video. Thank you.